Instincts are unlearned automatic behavior shown by all members of a species, like birds building a nest. Now, do people, like animals, have instincts? And if so, when are they more likely to use them? In the story you're about to read, To Build a Fire, it attempts to answer these questions. Hi, and welcome back. To Build a Fire by Jack London. Lesson Objectives. Literary Analysis. We're going to review the setting and conflict. Reading Strategy. Predict. Introduction to the story To Build a Fire. Literary Analysis. Setting and Conflict. A setting is where a story or event takes place. Authors can describe a setting to include geographic location, time, weather, and environment. In some stories, the setting can create the conflict of a character. It can even act as the antagonist or opponent of the main character. In To Build a Fire, the setting is the Yukon Wilderness, and the main character must battle the crippling cold to survive. The setting challenges him in other ways as well. As you read, notice details about this harsh setting and think about the choices the setting forces the character to make. Also, the setting helps the author create a mood for the story. Mood is the atmosphere or overall feeling of a piece of writing of literature. The mood can be cheerful, reflective, humorous, whimsical, or romantic. Reading strategy, predict. When you predict, you use text clues to guess what will happen next in the story. Predicting helps you become actively involved in what you're reading and gives you reasons to read on. To make sound predictions about what will happen in To Build a Fire, use the following strategies. Think about the personality, actions, and thoughts of the main character when predicting how he will respond to his situation. Note passages for foreshadowing or hints and clues about future plot events. To Build a Fire is a story of a younger miner who has come to the Yukon to find gold. He's traveling toward his camp on a cold, windy afternoon. Against the advice of a seasoned miner, he falls through some ice and gets his feet wet, necessitating building a fire to dry off and warm up. But things get more complicated as the story advances. The author. Born to an indifferent mother and an absent father, Jack London grew up in a poor neighborhood in Oakland, California. As a boy, his escape from poverty and loneliness was reading books. As a teenager, his escape was the sea. When he was 15, he borrowed money, bought a boat, and became an oyster pirate on the San Francisco Bay. At 17, he worked aboard a schooner that sailed the North Pacific. When he returned home, the only work he could find was low-paying manual labor. Fascinated by rags to riches stories he heard about people mining for gold in Canada's Yukon Territory, he sailed north at age 21. Striking it rich, London did not find gold in the Yukon, but he did find something valuable. Holed up during the fiercely cold Yukon winter, he read widely and listened to other gold prospectors tell stories about life in the frozen Northland. Inspired by their tales and his own experiences, London returned to Oakland and began to write. In 1899, magazines began publishing his stories, and his writing career was on its way. His novels, The Call of the Wild, The Sea Wolf, and White Fang, made him one of America's most popular and financially successful writers. almost a century after his death, readers are still captivated by his stark, suspenseful stories. And now, you are going to enjoy one of his stories.
Now, it's time for you to get a cup of coffee or tea and enjoy reading this story. Thanks for watching, and until the next one, bye!